Hi guys, this is T. Venkateswarlu, popularly known as T. Vishal. Welcome back to our channel Sandeep English World. Today I am going to continue the topic of articles. In the previous video you learnt about the usage of the indefinite article a or am depending upon the sound. Now in this video you are going to learn about the usage of this indefinite article in different contexts. There are some important contexts you have to know from the viewpoint of academic exams and competitive exams. Really, these points are very important. Let me talk about the very first point. The first one is, we use the indefinite article a or an in the context of one. To refer to the meaning of one, we use the indefinite article. For instance, there are 3 feet in a yard. There are 3 feet in a yard. A yard means in 1 yard. In the sense of the same, also we use the indefinite article. For example, birds of a feather flock together. Birds of a feather. A feather means the same feather. And the third point is, we use the indefinite article before a proper noun to refer to a stranger. For example, a Mr. Ravi has come for you. When we say a Mr. Ravi has come for you, we understand that Ravi is unknown to you. You know only his name. When you know the name of somebody, you have to say Ravi has come for you. When you say Ravi has come for you, you know what Ravi is and who Ravi is. And we use the indefinite article before the expressions of certain professions also. Before professions we use the indefinite article. For example, he is a doctor, a lawyer, an actor, an engineer, a teacher, a farmer, etc. And before the expressions of quantity we use the indefinite article. For example, a dozen, a score, a gross. A dozen means, you know, 12. A score means 20. A gross means 12 dozen. A hundred, a thousand, a couple, a lot of, a number of, etc. And we use the indefinite article in the other context, particularly before some small ailments. We use the indefinite article before small ailments. Only according to the modern usage, we use the indefinite article. For example, I am suffering from a fever. I am suffering from a headache, a stomachache, a cold, a cough. Only before the small ailments, we use the indefinite article. And we use the indefinite article to refer to, particularly before the expressions like the words. The plurals used as singulars. For example, a means, a series, a gallows, a barracks, in such a way. These are used as an innings. Seems to be plural, but practically it is used as singular. And in the context of certain exclamations also we use the indefinite article. For example, what a beautiful flower it is. What a hot day it is. In such a way, we use the indefinite article. And to refer to certain expressions, particularly in the expressions of price, speed, and ratio, where it means every, we use the indefinite article. For instance, I want bananas for 50 rupees a dozen. 50 rupees a dozen. A dozen means every dozen. I can ride my bike at 50 miles an hour. 50 miles an hour. An hour means every hour. I take food 3 times a day. 3 times a day means 3 times every day. And we use the indefinite article in the context of, particularly to refer to the words like few and little in a positive sense. For instance, I have a few friends in the town. When I say I have a few friends in the town, I have some friends. When I say I have few friends, it means I have no friends. I have a little money in my pocket, it means I have some money. When I say I have a little money in my pocket, I have no money. And to avoid ambiguity also, we use the indefinite article. For instance, when I say we have a black and a white kitten, we have two kittens. One is a black kitten and the other is a white kitten. When I say we have a black and white kitten, there is only one article in the usage. It means that there is only one kitten whose colors are black and white. And we use the indefinite article in different contexts, like in certain phrases. For instance, I dislike such a statement. When I say such a statement, such a book, such an experience, I have seen such a fellow. In such a way, we use such an experience or such a person. It is a phrase. In such phrases, we use. And I have seen many an accident, where it means many accidents, many a fellow, many a man, many an experience. So these are also a kind, certain phrases. In such phrases also we use the indefinite article, a or an, depending upon the sound. Anyhow, that these are all important contexts where we use the indefinite article. And I hope that you have understood this video clearly. And if you like this video, you can subscribe to our channel. Click on the bell icon for more updates. Feel free to put your comments and suggestions in the comment box. And really, I am very happy to be ready for another video. And I'll see you again in the next video. And until then, take care. Bye-bye. Happy learning.